Hello everyone and welcome back to
The Vi Bits.
I'm Maddie Riggs and I'm here with my famous co-host,
Jessie Ralph. Hope you guys are all having a great week, but
you're probably wondering why we're here. Well, for those who don't know, a week before Easter, most of the kids in our church community received an Easter pack. Yeah. Now, we were pretty bummed, weren't we, about not getting one?
They looked really good, so like, pretty upset,
but
it's okay.
But you guys are probably here because you have received your Vi pack. Mm. Now, if you have not received a Vi pack, you can contact Felicity Rouse or Peter Riggs down below. Mm. Get their contact details, their email, their phone number. But yeah. You're probably here because there's something in that Vi pack.
Yeah. So all of you who got a Vi pack should have received a bouncy ball. We're going to show you some cool thing to do with the bouncy ball, or just a game to play with the bouncy ball that, you know, we've gotten pretty good at, you know.
Yeah, we've researched quite a lot, so I think we're semi-professionals of this sport. Anyone can do it, even if you're not that sporty.
Yeah.
So just watch this space. Yeah. Olympics, come hit me up. Okay, but what do you do with this sort of
game?
You need a toilet roll and you need a bounce ball. Now, I know toilet rolls are a pretty touchy subject at the moment, but you can use other things such as a mug, but it probably will be very different to this game.
Yeah.
Now, we would love it if you guys also sent us a video of you doing the same game as us and let us know how many things you get, how many times you get this ball through. So, let's go.
Yeah.
So you bounce the ball and then you try to get it through. You try to get it through.
Okay, I lost it.
Okay, wait.
We're pretty good at this.
Okay, yeah, that's... semi-professionals. Okay. So, Jessie, we would love to see also how many times you got it in a row.
Yeah, so...
Because as...
Send a video of how many times you get it below.
Or comment down below.
Or comment how many times. And the winner...
will get a prize.
What? We don't know what it is.
Yeah.
But...
It's going to be good. So
we now have our question of the week, which is, what decade do you wish you were living in and why?
Well, for me, I would probably want to live in the 1800s. Shout out to my mother, Rachel Riggs. Go hit her up on the Instagram, FamRiggs6. But the reason why 1800s has such like an impact on me is probably Jane Austen. Mm. I'm probably seeing it from a Jane Austen perspective. Very pretty, very bold, very gentleman, and probably not seeing it from other perspectives. So I guess I'm just seeing the nice part of it. But what about you, Jessie?
I think I like the 80s because of the cool like clothes they wear, like the colours and all the... And the music is pretty good too, so like, yeah, I think it's just the 80s, right?
The 80s.
Yeah. So comment down below what you think is the best decade, or
we would love to hear
what you guys think. So, yeah. We now have the verse of the week, which is Philippians 4:6.
And it says, don't be anxious about anything, but in prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And I think this is such an important verse, because as we were talking about before, we can kind of lose our trust in God definitely during this fearful time. But if we just keep relying on God a lot more and spending more time with Him, I guess. So just think about that verse and what it means to you, I think.
I'm just going to kind of leave you with that and just,
So, I guess that is it from us.
Nugget!
It's not your segment!
Jeez, you get Sunday, you get every Sunday.
Ooh. Nugget one. For once, we just want to know about us. Well, sorry to leave you on that sour note, but we hope you have an amazing
week, guys. We'll catch you next time.
Catch you later.